Hey Pentesters, the Flipper Zero just got a major firmware update, version 1.1.2, bringing lots of new features and essential fixes that makes it even better. Let's go over what's new and why it matters to you after the intro. I'm Sandy from LAB401.com. This new firmware update brings big changes to how Flipper handles power, clocks, alarms, and other essential features. First up, there's a new power subsystem initialization routine. This changes how the Flipper Zero manages its battery gauge. If you're running an older firmware, you won't be able to see the battery status correctly. The Flipper Zero team recommends resetting the battery gauge if you experience issues. You can do this by either disconnecting the battery or using the gauge tool. These updates ensure more accurate battery tracking. Another major improvement is the update to the clock and alarm system. There's a new RTC, real-time clock initialization flow, which means older firmware will struggle to handle alarms properly. If you're downgrading, make sure to switch alarms before switching back. Now let's talk about what's really cool here. You can configure clocks and alarms directly in settings. Plus, the alarm can wake up the Flipper Zero from shutdown mode. Of course, as long as the battery isn't fully drained. This is super useful if you want to schedule your Flipper to power on automatically. NFC got significant upgrade too. The Flipper team has fixed the NFC emulation freezes and added a bunch of new parsers, including NDEF and improvements to ISO 14443-4A support. This makes the Flipper Zero much more reliable for NFC cloning, reading, and emulation. For RFID, there are important changes, like proper block ordering when writing EM4100 to 5577 blank tags. If you've had trouble with certain RFID cards, this update should make a big difference. Next up is infrared. As usual, they've added new devices to the Universal Remote Library, so if you love using your Flipper Zero as a remote control, you'll find it supports even more TVs and gadgets. Big improvements also came to bad USB. There are now mockable layouts, and the new UI makes it easier to switch between USB and BLE modes. USB / HID remote functionality also got an upgrade, with faster click rates and a new maximum shortcut in a mouse clicker. Attention developers, the Flipper Zero now has new JavaScript modules for GUI, event loops, GPIO, and other systems. They've released version 0.1 of the SDK and a project template to help you start building for the Flipper. If you're interested in developing apps, now is the time. There are also improvements to GPIO. Specifically, the UART bridge now has a better user experience. For sub-gigahertz, they added new keylock keys, which opens up more options for signal replay and other advanced tasks. The core system, called Fury, has seen some major enhancements, added new thread life cycle module, and made the event loop more efficient. This means fewer crashes and more stable performance across the board. Also, Firmware, the hardware abstraction layer, received a fix for the random number generator. Before, it could sometimes return all zeros if exhausted. There's also a new RTC alarm API and other stability fixes. Moving on to storage, there's a fix for a bug that prevented some folders from being renamed. The toolbox documentation has also been updated to explain how to use the bit buffer more clearly. Plus, the Wi-Fi dev board documentation has been cleaned up and updated. Lastly, if you use the desktop app, there's a new security feature. The desktop switch will now require you to enter your PIN at startup if you have one set, adding an extra layer of security. Everybody at LAB401.com is really impressed with the work the Flipper Zero team has done for firmware version 1.1.2. They continue to push the boundaries and make this device even more powerful and reliable for all of us. Of course, before I leave you, a quick shout out to the new contributors. Thank you for your contribution. Thanks for watching this video. Before you go, please do me a favor and subscribe to this channel. LAB401 is not only the best pentesting tools distributor in Europe, we are also putting lots of effort into providing the community with valuable information and tutorials. You can access these on LAB401.com and here on YouTube. So visit LAB401.com, your pentesting tools distributor, always with the best service and the best price. Take care and see you next time.